Hi everyone, Mr. Mike from the gadgetguyreview.com, and I'm going to do a how-to quick video on how to book your Disneyland tickets. It's actually not as straightforward as you think because there's just a lot of stuff on the website here. So let me help you navigate this. I actually am on multiple browsers actually trying to get tickets, and I'm going to show you the process from beginning to end. First of all, you're going to want to either Google or go to this, which is disneyland.disney.go.com. You know, Google's probably easier. Just type in Disneyland tickets and it'll take you to the screen. There's a lot of verbiage over here. You don't really have to worry about all that, but you might want to take a look at that. That's kind of COVID related and some updates to the resort. So it's a little confusing. You know, where can I actually click on to get these tickets, right? So if you go all the way through this page, you'll see if you click on any of these things, it's still not going to take you to the tickets. Okay, so there's a couple places that you can go to. Let me show you the most straightforward. It's this thing. So when you kind of scroll it up, it's going to stay at the top there. So what you want to click on, if you want a California Adventure, you select that. If you want to do Disneyland, select that. And by the way, this is for Disneyland California. Click on that, and still you're not really there yet. Okay, you got this verbiage here that's going to confuse you, but it's the same as before. So if you read that already, keep going, and it's going to say, really small little button here says buy tickets. That's where you want to go. All this other stuff, you can click on it. You're going to navigate away from where you want to go. Buy the tickets. Okay. All right. So now this is where you're going to wait. Number one, this is kind of a waiting room. You do not want to navigate away from this page. You want to keep it open. It says don't refresh the page or select back, or else you're going to lose your place in line. Okay. So you're going to make sure you're in there. And they're saying the approximate wait time is more than an hour. I have this open on multiple browsers already, and it's been over an hour, so that's accurate. So while you're waiting, you might want to take a look at what are the ticket types that are available. Click on that. It's going to open up another tab. This is going to show you all the dates that you can start booking this thing. So it's going to show you, for example, this ticket's just open today. When I'm filming, this is actually on the 15th, but actually it's not opening until the 30th, so April 30th, 2021. And here are all the other dates you can see here. And they're only booking it out for, I think, just 60 days. So even in July, you can't go into it. But you can take a look at what's available. Now, it's important for you to buy the kind of ticket that you are going to book. So first you buy the ticket, and then you're going to book it. So click on this. And now you're going to look at all the different types of tickets that are available. Again, look up here. That is that COVID stuff. If you read that, don't worry about it. You want to go down here. And again, I'm still waiting, by the way, and I'm going to be waiting for a while here. And you go down here. Here are all the types of tickets that are available. Okay. Skip through all that other stuff we just saw. There's one day, there's tier one, tier two, tier three, tier four. If you're not very familiar with this, this is very similar to what Disney had before. Basically, the pricing actually hasn't even changed since pre-COVID. So that's pretty cool that actually the price has not gone up. Expected to go up pretty soon, though. There's two-day tickets, three-day, multi-day tickets, okay, and park hoppers, which allow you to go back and forth between the parks. Now, here's the difference on the different tier parks. If you want, this is important to know before you buy these tickets, okay? So let's say, you know, you want to go on, you want to have anything available, you want to get the tier five ticket. So that's going to be right here where it's going to be actually 154 for adults, 146 for children. If you know you're going to go on maybe not a Saturday, Sunday, so upcoming, for example, you look down here on the dates, you see over here, these are good to go. That's Monday through Friday in May, but then once you get into June, it's Monday through Thursday. If you want to go Friday, Saturday, Sunday, obviously you should still buy the tier five tickets, but if you're going to do something between Monday through Thursday, tier four tickets, and that's going to drop the price by, you know, like $15. So that's a good deal there, 139, 132. Tier three, even more limited, Monday through Thursday here. But then in June, only Monday, only Tuesday, Wednesday. Tier two, even more limited, okay? Only a few dates at least coming out here. And then tier one are not even available. And those were the good tickets, right? Those were the good tickets that were only 104 or 98 for a child, okay? So just wanted to give you a quick idea of how we do that. Again, you're going to wait over here. You might want to open several browser windows, by the way, just to make sure. If you lose your place here, you're going to have to go all the way back. So make sure you don't do that. I'm going to just kind of, instead of having you guys sit through a long, long video watching this for hours, as soon as I get in, I'm going to do a quick screen share and show you that as well. All right. Coming back just a few hours later, and here it says, the turn that began, and we have basically 10 minutes to get on, or if they're going to actually kick us off. So make sure you get in and make sure you get on as soon as you can. There was actually a little chime that was here, and then it says your queue is no longer valid. So there's been an error, you've been rejected, and you have to get a new place in line. So be careful about that. I did open another window though, however, so I'm going to jump to that. Let's see if I have it here. All right, so thank goodness I and this is what I recommend most people to do, save multiple tabs here so you have, just keep your place in line just in case. This is the way the screen is gonna look. You got that COVID stuff again. Scroll down a little bit and here's that screen that's gonna get you your tickets. So it's gonna say here, theme park tickets or theme reservations are required. You can look at the calendar again. And so I'm gonna look at that calendar again to see what's available. And some dates have already disappeared here. It's going to show all the dates. And of course, all those Saturdays are all taken up. Go back here and you're going to be able to choose basically the type of ticket you want. If you want it by the one day, they're going to show you what's available for that one day. So of course, it's very, very expensive in this first month. But select. So I'm going to select, let's see if there is something available on this 29th. They're going to tell you how much you're going to say, and we're getting a couple tickets here and a couple for the kids. So we're going to pull those, grab those, and you're going to be able to do your selections. So I'm going to stop at this point. Since a lot of this is going to just be processing the transaction, but just to give you a sense. And again, so be careful. There's a lot of people that have gotten kicked out. It is a little tricky sometimes, but hopefully this video has been helpful for everyone.